Welcome to A Star Is Blues at TAFE of Maastricht at Blues number 805, and I'm really happy to welcome Julian Radcliffe. What was your first interaction with TAFE? How did you start working with them, and how was, of course, the Artlos Register founded?
The Artlos Register was founded 25 years ago, and I started it at the request of Sotheby's. I claim no credit for the idea, it was their idea. And we took over the database, which had been assembled by a not-for-profit organization in New York, which didn't, called IFAR, International Foundation for Art Research, who didn't have enough funding to make the whole project international and commercial. And so we started in 1990, and we built up a database of 500,000 stolen and fake and looted and missing items, both art and antiques. And we undertake 450,000 paid searches a year, each done by a member of staff, not done entirely electronically, done with an art historian involved, to try and make certain that the stolen or fake items do not re-enter the marketplace. And we were asked to become part of the vetting organization at TEFAF about 14 years ago. And every year here we search about 12,000 items being offered for sale in order to keep up the standards of TEFAF, which are, I think, the highest anywhere in the world in terms of vetting for condition, authenticity, the description, and title, i.e. the provenance, and whether the person selling the item and the person buying the item will have a proper title.
And in practice, if you could tell us a little bit more, how does the procedure of actually finding art and researching the work happen?
The list comes in from a dealer with a full description of the item, and hopefully a full provenance and a very good image or a number of images. We then take what we see and interrogate the database. We don't immediately say this is a Reynolds painting, how many stolen Reynoldses do we have? Because it's possible that the attribution has changed. This picture might have been registered with us as stolen, and they didn't know it was by Reynolds. So we search by what we see, which hopefully doesn't change very much, although clearly it changes a bit with conservation and reframing and so on. But we search by what we see. Then we search by what we're told, which is we check the provenance, we check the artist's name, we may go and look at the resume, and then we check that it's not on the database and there are no red flags in the provenance, i.e. if the picture was in Europe between 1934 and 1945, we want to check that it hadn't been taken by the Nazis. Or if the picture was in Kuwait at a certain time during the Iraq invasion. So we have red flags, dealers' names, dates, and so on, which mean that we do more research if those are involved. So that's an outline. It's very detailed, time-consuming work, and there is no electronic system.
How many pieces do you find, average? And let's just stay with TAFE of there any sort of problem you might appear on. Yeah.
Most of the issues that we surface are resolvable. They may be something which was reported to us as stolen. It's been recovered and is now being stolen, sold legitimately. So many of the matches don't turn out to be really stolen items. Some of the things we identify, there is a grey area. Nobody's 100% sure. And we have to take a judgment. Maybe we've researched it many times. We've never found anybody who could claim it. Maybe it could be sold. Maybe it should not be sold. So there is a fine judgment to be made there. But the number of items which get withdrawn here is very few. One or two a year. But it's probably fair to say that if we weren't here, then the dealers would not be so careful.
It's
the same with the vetting committee. If the vetting committee did not include very well-regarded independent experts, then a dealer might take a bit more of a risk. With the vetting committee, he's got to make certain he does his homework on provenance, authenticity, condition. He must do it before he comes to the fair.
Do you work mostly with private requests, or are requests coming even from states, or auction houses, or governments, or?
We work with everybody. So the biggest numbers will come from auction houses. Many come from dealers. The police often ask when they are suspicious of items they've found. So do customs. So do ministries of culture. Anybody accepting a donation or a gift, the tax authorities, private collectors buying, conservators who want to check that they are not being asked to do something they shouldn't do on a picture. So everybody who's anybody who is buying, selling, financing, valuing, insuring, moving art and antiques should at some time be checking with us.
Well, that sounds amazing. Thank you very much. Thank you for your time and joining us for this short fireside chat. We wish you a very good fair.